With Socket.io, you can easily add real-time communication to your billion-dollar side project. And today, I'm going to show you how to do it in Flutter with Dart. Socket.io has packages for building both a server and a client. To start building a server, you have to add Socket.io as a dependency to your Dart project. To do that, simply run dart pub add socket.io or manually add it to your pubspec.yaml file. And don't forget to run dart pub get at the end. Please note that this runs version 2 of socket.io. That will become important later on when we start implementing our client. Then you can import the package and create a server instance. To start listening to events, you use the on function of that instance. It takes two parameters. The first is the name of the event we want to listen for, and the second is a handler function that gets called every time that event is received. The handler function always takes one parameter, which is the data object that is sent along with the event. A connection event is received every time a client connects to the server. The data it sends along is a reference to the client's socket. You can then start listening to events from that specific client by using the on function on the socket instance instead of the server. To move a client into a room, you can use the join function and pass it the room name. For sending or emitting events, you use the emit function. You pass it the event name as the first and the data object you want to send along as the second parameter. There are four main ways you can send events from the server to the client. The first is using the emit function on the client's socket. This will send the event to just that client. The second is using it on the broadcast object. This will send the event to everybody except that client. You can also use the emit function on the server instance. This will send the event to every connected client. And if you want to send events to rooms, you can specify the room name in the to function before calling emit. And if you want to send the event to more than one room, you can also chain multiple to functions behind each other. Calling the emit function on the socket will not send the event to that client, while calling it on the server object will. Before emitting an event, a union operation is performed on all clients that receive the event, so that every event is only received once by each client. To actually start listening to events, all you have to do is call the listen function and specify a port to listen on. Before you start implementing the client, you have to look at what version of Socket.io your server is running. For example, if you implemented your server with Dart, as I've shown you, it runs version 2. However, the newest versions are 3 and 4, and they are not backwards compatible. So there are two versions of the Socket.io client package. Version 1 of the client is compatible with version 2 of Socket.io, while version 2 of the client is compatible with version 3 and 4. So choose the correct dependency and add it to your pubspec.yaml file. To create your client socket, import the package and call the IO function. It takes two parameters and returns the socket. The first is the connection URL to your server, and the second is a map containing options. One option you need to provide is a list containing the transport layers you want to use. You should choose WebSocket, but you can also choose polling. Another option you can add is force new connection. If you plan on connecting multiple times during an app lifecycle, set this value to true. To send events to the server, you call the emit function on the socket instance. And to receive events, you use the on function. They work exactly the same way as they do on the server. However, the only target you can send events to is the server. The client also has lifecycle methods like onConnect and onDisconnect that are called whenever that special event happens. Thank you for watching this video to the end. As a reward, I have a full working example of a server and a client built with Dart and Flutter in the GitHub repository linked in the description below. And if you enjoyed the video, please consider liking and subscribing to the channel.